Tyler Durden is one of the sickest characters in movie history. Although there are a couple things that make this character so special, the one that stands out the most is his phenomenal body language. A lot of people wish they could have a body language like Tyler. In this video, I will break his body language down so you can apply it to real life and use it to your advantage. Enjoy. You can already see how Tyler Durden just talks when he wants to talk, okay? A lot of people are afraid to just speak up, you know. But Tyler Durden just, when he thinks there's something to say, or he just, you know, thinks about something and he wants to say, he just speaks up, alright? That's very rarely seen nowadays because people are just like, oh no, talk as less as possible, which is usually a good thing, but with Tyler Durden's character, it just matches perfectly, you know? Says what he thinks, and you can see right here that could have been like a weird situation where both are just kind of in silence looking the other way, which is all right, but you know, Tyler Durden just talks no matter if the guy next to him, you know, gives a shit or not. That's just a cool trait right here.
Unable or unwilling to perform the duties listed on the safety card, please ask a flight attendant to receive you.
You know, without saying hello or anything, and you can see he just starts talking and instantly he just gets attention, all right? He doesn't need to, you know, have this weird small talk and stuff. He just starts talking and just kind of expects people to give him attention, and that's what, you know, usually happens also. It's just pretty, pretty great characteristic from Tyler Durden here.
It's a lot of responsibility. Want to switch seats?
And here also kind of challenging him. He could have had now a boring small talk with, oh yeah, it's so tough to sit here, you know. Now he's just saying what he thinks, and I think that's very important with Tyler Durden here.
I'm the man for that particular job. An exit-door procedure at 30,000 feet. Mm-hmm. The illusion of safety. Yeah, I guess so. Know why they put oxygen masks on planes?
Again, just completely changing topic. You know, not really anything, you know, that had anything to do with the conversation, but he just switches topics because he wants to talk about that now. And he thinks of it and he's just like, yeah, say that now. You know, a lot of people be like, oh no, don't say that, don't say that. And just in their own head all the time. Tyler Durden just, everything he thinks, he just gets out and talks about. And I think that's pretty much great.
Okay, you can breathe. Oxygen gets you high.
And here also, the way he talks, he starts whispering. Whisper is a great way to just have people listen to you, because people tend to lean in to listen to your words. And that's just a great way to get attention from people.
In a catastrophic emergency, you're taking giant panic breaths. Suddenly you become euphoric, docile. You accept your fate. It's all right here.
Also right here, you can see the way he just handed that over, you know. That was in his, this book was in his space right now before, and then he just gave it to him. I know that's a pretty normal thing to do, but if you do such things, that's pretty much widening your space, all right? Making yourself bigger in a way. Because the things you own are kind of resembling you. So if you, for example, you get to a desk and the first thing you do is sit down and then place your phone on one side, you know. So I will just paint it. So that's the desk right here. You sit down and the first thing you do is put in a phone here, put in your, I don't know, something out of your pocket here, then you already have just, and you're sitting here as a person, you just already have that much space, okay? That's just how objects can help you just make yourself bigger. And that's also, he used that to just invade the narrator's personal space here. So this is, you know, right in his personal space. It basically says that, you know, I can put my stuff where I want to. And that's just very dominant. Also, look at the posture of those people. I think that's a great, Right here, you know, you see how tall is Durden, pretty much straight up in the seat, chin up, chin elevated, face turned, not whole body turned, but just face, and then the narrator is just kind of, you know, then forward, you know, chin down, kind of all the faces down. It's just, it's an awful posture, you know. You can just see who of them is more confident in the way they position themselves, their body. And then also here, the slow turn right here, have a look. You know, he just turns at his own pace, okay? And that's another big man move, because big men never, like, you know, someone tells him to come, they don't start sprinting, you know, they don't start running. They just walk slowly, take their own time. Move at their own pace. That's another big man thing to do. And also, notice how he instantly locks eye contact. He's having a very strong eye contact. Although you have sunglasses on, you can see that he's just, you know, locked on him. Which is also, again, very dominant. And you can see the narrator often just, you know, kind of looking away, looking somewhere else. With Tyler Durden, it is either he's looking forward, or he's having strong eye contact with him, right? So he just less fidgeting around with his face, and this just shows that he's way more confident.
What do you do? What do you mean? What do you do for a living? Why?
And then here, just the short answers, okay? You know, he doesn't tell him his life story, because honestly, if you're in a plane, it's just like a 10-minute, you know this guy since 10 minutes, you know. People nowadays would be like, oh yeah, so I'll do this in my free time. And then last time I got this deal, and they talk for hours and hours. The other person doesn't really care. It's kind of regretting asking what the other person's doing. You know, this Tyler Durden knows it. Everyone really knows it. So that's why I think small talk is bullshit. He's just saying what he thinks and just having short answers. That's another big man characteristic. Big men don't talk around. Big men say less than necessary. Write that down, all right?
So you can pretend like you're interested.
And here, right there. You know, again, just saying what he means, what he thinks, you know? He doesn't like to just act like everything is great and, you know, kind of keep his thoughts in his head. He just gets them out. A lot of people are afraid to say something like that. But it's the truth, you know. A lot of people do not care and act like they care. It's like, how are you? You know, no one really cares how you are, really. Just like this, you know, mandatory. How are you? Oh, I'm good. You? How are you? Oh, yeah, I'm good. You know, it's just like, okay. You know, none of you really care, so why are you even asking? And he just tells him right in the face, all right? And that's just very, very confident right here. Can also see how the narrator is kind of, you know, kind of unexpected, you know, scrunching up his face. You will see a lot of these going on. You know, he's definitely not expecting this, because pretty much no one right here, no one in this kind of time is expecting just honesty with just like, how are you? Yo, you don't really care, do you? No one is expecting this answer. That just shows that you're confident and really, you know, really say what you think. That's just a big man trait right here.
Okay. You have a kind of sick desperation in your life?
Here again. So, do you have some kind of sick desperation in your life? He just says what he thinks, and also slow moving forward while talking and while having eye contact. You know, looking to the side, moving to forward while having eye contact. It's really, really something tough to do. A lot of people struggle with it. Even just holding eye contact while talking, it's tough, because you're in your own head thinking about what you say. But it just comes across as very, very confident. It's a great skill to have. Really try to learn it. It's a big man thing, all right?
Okay.
exact same briefcase.
Again, it's just really unnecessary information. He doesn't really care. And he shows him that he doesn't really care by just, you know, the little smirk, not really answering, just like, okay, you know, who gives a shit? I don't. You can just, you know, also smirk's a great thing. Big man smirk. Big man don't show their teeth, big man smirk. I don't tell you to never show your teeth, but if you show your teeth too often, it just comes across as submissive. You know, in the ape kingdom, alpha comes, beta show their teeth. Please don't hurt me in this kind of manner. So if you show your teeth too often, it just comes across as submissive. So watch out, smirk more often. Smirks are a great way to kind of avoid that. It's just big man thing, all right? And then here, the one word, change of topics, short answer, really. Okay, that's two things right here. Big man, decide what the people around them are talking about. You know, and then also just saying less than necessary. You could have been like, oh, so my business is this, and last night I sold this much soap, and he just says soap. That's all that's necessary, because, you know, why should you say more? Saying less than necessary, write that down, really. Pin it on your wall, just so you always see it. It's very, 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 very important and very powerful. That's a big man thing, alright?
We make and they sell soap. The yardstick of civilization. And this is how I met Tyler Durden.
Did you know if you mix equal parts of gasoline and frozen orange juice concentrate, you can make napalm?
Right here, this was... I feel like that was kind of messed up here, because, I mean, I know it was a lot of information, but in Tyler Durden's position, I wouldn't have talked that fast. Usually, big men don't talk fast. Big men talk at their own pace. Remember that. Don't speed up. Don't be like a little kid trying to fill the space where you're allowed to talk till you interrupt it again. You're not a little kid. You're a big man, all right? So you can talk slowly. People will listen to you, okay?
No, I did not know that. Is that true?
Again, here, just the position of the narrator hinged up, you know, that's just disgusting, really. He's just, you know, hinged up forward, having an awful posture, chin down, and then on the other side, it's just him, chin up, just, you know, turn his head. It's just a way better posture here. Again, the little smirk here. And here you can just also see, you know, that's kind of slightly, you know, overdone. But the chin up, I know he's looking forward to, you know, look over the seats. But he's just having a way better posture. You can just see it here, how he's hinged up, chin down, face, you know, kind of leaned forward. Also, leaning forward is a submissive move. You know, in dates, you can do it just to, you know, seem like you're interested in the other person. But it's still a submissive move. And you can just see the difference in posture right here. It's just really, really different. Also, how, if you notice, the narrator's face is facing towards him. His eyes are facing towards him. You can see how Tyler Durden does not care. Everything of his body is faced this way. His face, his eyes, everything. And that's pretty much the demonstration of a big man, okay? The big man gets the attention of all the people around them without even, you know, really trying and looking away. That just shows that everyone around you respects you. That's a great demonstration here. And here you can just see, you know, he tried to make a joke, and Tyler Durden doesn't really react, okay? And, you know, he just takes his time first, and also he just doesn't react because, you know, he could laugh, but if he doesn't really find it funny, why should he laugh, right? A lot of people doing fake laughs can be useful to their person if you're trying to win friends, but, you know, it's just still fake, right? So Tyler Durden's again... He doesn't find it funny, so he doesn't laugh, right? Just remains holding strong eye contact. And also embracing the silence here, another big man trait. people are scared of silence usually. Try to fill it. Or, you know, oh no, it's silent now. I don't have to say anything. No, you don't. Just embrace the silence. You know, remaining strong eye contact. It's just a big man, alright? See, now, he just went silent and the other person, again, tried to fill the silence, explaining himself. That's just what you do. When you get silent, people start talking more about themselves, you know? That's why I say less than necessary, because that will kind of result in silence, and then people will try to fill it and try to talk about themselves, and then you just don't know much about them, but they know less about you. That's really a great trade-off right here. That's a big man thing.
It's very clever. Thank you.
Again, the little smirk, not showing his teeth, because, you know, if he fake smiles, not showing his teeth is just a better option. Smirks, big man smirk, alright? Notice, just wait that down. Big man smirk.
How's it working out for you? What? Being clever?
Again, change of topic, he decides what the people around him are talking about. That was kind of funny, but also, you know, he decides when to leave. He doesn't wait for the other person, although he was sitting on the window, you know. It's pretty much a position where you have to wait that the other person leaves first. He does not care. He's the big man. When he wants to go, he will go, all right? You will often see it when the conversation is kind of fizzling out. The big man's just like, all right, I got better shit to do. It was great with you, but I got stuff to work on. I got stuff to do. I will leave now, alright? A lot of people are scared to, you know, they will just sit in silence, be like, yeah. I really want to be here, but, you know, I'm scared to just walk off. He just leaves, okay? Also doesn't say goodbye, because it's not necessary. No, made a little joke there, but that big man leave, alright? Big man finish the conversation. Hope you enjoyed, hope you learned something. Till next vid, bye.